Welcome back to ABC Avenue. I'm so glad you're here with me today so we can read another book. I have the sweetest, nicest story for you guys today. I think you're gonna love it. Our book today is called Scarlet and the Do-Good Dragons. Isn't that fun? Scarlet and the Do-Good what? Dragons! What do you think is gonna happen in this book? We better read and see, huh? Now, before we get started, I want to say a really quick thank you to the author, Bradley Mariano, and the illustrator, Philip Goodwin, for giving me permission to read this book on my channel. It's such a fun story. I can't wait to read it with you. Let's get started. Okay. Scarlet and the Do-Good Dragon. Again, it was by Bradley Mariano and Philip Goodwin. Ready? Meet Scarlet. She lives in a fairly ordinary kingdom with fairly ordinary houses and fairly ordinary townspeople who wear tremendously ordinary shoes. Here's Scarlet. Does that sound about like where you live? I live in a really ordinary place and I definitely wear ordinary shoes. How about you? I bet you have cool shoes, huh? I bet. Let's see what's gonna happen. Here's Scarlet. What's gonna happen in this story? But something about Scarlet is not ordinary at all. She has a few of the most extraordinary friends. They are large and fierce and blow fire. They can shake the kingdom's houses with their thunderous roars. Did you see here, Scarlet? What's she standing in? Can you see that? Let me see. Can you see that? Let me try again. Is that a footprint? And what about over here? What do you see in these shadows? Oh my gosh. What do you think shakes the houses with their roars?
You better go see.
She is friends with dragons. One day, Scarlet had an idea. My friends are large, fierce, and blow fire. But deep down inside, they have the kindest, most courageous hearts. I think we could do a lot of good, she thought. What do you think? Can they do a lot of good? Probably just like you, huh? Let's see what they do. Good thinking, Scarlet. That's a good thought. So, Scarlet started the first ever full-service dragon helpline in the kingdom. Do Good Dragons. And the phone never stopped ringing. Scarlet and the Do Good Dragons hurried to the side of little Zane, who was afraid of the scary shadows in his bedroom. Oh, look. He was a little afraid in his bed. Ice cream? Did they bring him ice cream to make him feel better? And they brought a flashlight so he wouldn't be afraid, huh? They rushed to assist Quentin's family when they forgot their matches. They dashed to rescue Harmony's favorite pink balloon. There was so much good to be done. Way to go, they're helping all these people. Look, they're helping. This family went camping and they're gonna help him make s'mores, look. And then he's gonna fly after the balloon that got away. Oh, very cool. What are they gonna do now? Oh no. One really busy day, Scarlet was not feeling well. Not well at all. The Do Good Dragon helpline rang, but no one answered. Oh no, look at Scarlet. Oh, there's the phone. What's gonna happen? Scarlet's not well. What should we do? The dragons exclaimed. Without you, we can do no good. And so many people need our do-gooding. Oh dear, do-good dragons, Scarlet said. Everything you need to know about doing good, I have already taught you. You are large and you are fierce, but you have the kindest, most courageous hearts. You can do anything. So what happened? They were afraid that they couldn't do any good without Scarlet's help. Is that true? No. They have goodness inside of them and they can use their good hearts to help people, huh? Let's see what they do. Let's see what happens. The phone rang again, and this time the do-good dragons answered it themselves. They ran to help little Sybil, who wanted someone to play dress-up with. Look! She put a little skirt on his leg and a necklace on his toes! And where's the hat? Can you see that? It's on his tail. Oh my gosh. Who else are they going to help? There's the phone. Here's the dress-ups. What do you think? And they rushed to the side of Darby, who just needed a hug after a bad day at school. Oh. The do-good dragons helped Mr. McGulligan get the secret ingredient for his extra special soup. There was so much good to be done. So much good! What are they going to do now? Gosh, they've been really helpful. How have they helped people? Do you remember any? They helped a family make their s'mores. Do you remember that? And catch a balloon. And what else? I bet you remember some. I remember they helped Darby get a hug. They helped the boy who was afraid of the shadows. What else? The dress-ups. Do you remember that? And they helped Mr. McGulligan find the ingredient he needed for his soup. Let's see what happens next. Busy with all of their do-gooding, the dragons almost forgot the person who needed their help the most. Who was it? Scarlet! Let's go see her, they said. And this time, we will bring a few of our new friends. They may wear ordinary shoes, but deep down inside, they have the kindest, most courageous hearts. They can do a lot of good! And off they went. They're gonna go help Scarlet, huh? How do you think they're gonna help her? I will sit here all night in case there are scary shadows, Zane promised Scarlet. And here is the warmest fire in case you get chilly, Quentin added. I brought you a pink balloon, or 29, to make you extra happy, said Harmony. Shared Harmony. Isn't that nice? Her friends are giving back the kindness that the dragons, the do-gooders, did to them. Look, let me show you. Oh, you see all those pink balloons? Whoa! Have you ever seen so many balloons? That would be cool, huh? And I brought you some board games so we can have some fun, exclaimed Sybil. Oh my gosh, it's Princess Scarlet's Tower Race. You start here, there's a slide, and some lava, watch out! Oh, where do we go? How do I get there? We have to follow the path all around, and huzzah! We made it to the tower, Princess Scarlet! Good job! Here is the biggest hug, said Darby, to make you feel better on a bad day. And I made you some of my extra special soup. Secret ingredient and all, said Mr. McGulligan. Look, more of her friends are repaying the kindness that the do-good dragon showed them. Darby's giving her a hug, and Mr. McGulligan made some soup. Here's the pictures. See those? Cool, huh? Because, dear Scarlet, you are small, but you are fierce. And you have the kindest, most courageous heart, said the do-good dragons. You can do anything. And she did. With her dragon-like spirit and a little help from her extraordinary friends, the kingdom was not so ordinary after all. The end. Let me show you these pictures. I love Scarlet over here with her dragons. And all her friends. Wasn't that an amazing book? You guys all have kind and courageous hearts, just like the dragons and their friends, and like Scarlet too, huh? Oh gosh, I love that story. I want to say a quick thank you again to Bradley and Philip for giving me permission to read their book on my channel. I love this story. And I love even more about this story is that Scarlet is a real girl. And do you know what? Scarlet was fighting with cancer. Isn't that sad? So do you know what? These two nice guys, Bradley Mariano and Philip Goodwin, they wrote this book about Scarlet. And all the proceeds of the story go to a children's cancer fund. Isn't that amazing? So make sure you go to the description beneath the video, and there's links there where you can go get the book and support this great fund and encourage kids who have kind and courageous hearts just like Scarlet. Thanks again for reading with me today. I can't wait to see you next week for another book. Have a good week. Bye.